Speaking about education, we of course are celebrating World Maths Day today, and sitting beside me, we do have that maths teacher. And if you're on TikTok or any social media, you would know exactly who I'm speaking about. It of course is Miss Nina Hanekom here today to chat to us more about maths, the education system, you know, and just to celebrate maths because she is such a lover of maths. So welcome to the show. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me. Yeah.
So let's just pause because, okay, you know, this is your 10th year in teaching, and you've been teaching for such a long time. It is actually a decade today. So how would you explain, you know, the advancement of education through your decade of teaching today?
Yeah, so I think mostly in terms of technology, that has advanced a lot. You know, we even have online schools now, which 10 years ago we absolutely didn't have. Like, it would have been unheard of having Zoom lessons as your classes. And also just like, I am still an in-person teacher, and in my own classroom, for example, technology has made things so much easier. So kids can have like e-books instead of textbooks. You know, they don't have to carry that super heavy bag around all the time. And I can post like notes, worksheets, videos and things on Google Classroom, for example. There are also so many online resources available to the kids, which in the past they just didn't have. You know, maybe 10 years ago, if someone was absent, they would have to like go and ask their teacher, "Ma'am, please, can you help me with this? I missed this yesterday." Now, you know, you can go on YouTube, type in anything. Yeah, you can find anything that you really are looking for. So I think technology really, on the one hand, has been great. But on the other hand, you know, we live in South Africa. There's so many kids that don't have resources, that maybe don't even have access to a phone, for example. So it's so difficult. The kids that do have access, they're just going, you know, like moving up, 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 where the rest of the kids are kind of being left behind. So that is definitely the negative about almost the technological advancement that we've had.
And speaking about the students, you know, and maths in general, so as mentioned earlier with numeric in the conversation that Lua had with him, rather, you know, maths is not everyone's favorite. It's not number one on every student's list. I, for one, can attest to that. So how do you say you've incorporated, you know, that you students remain present in your lessons that you give? How do you maintain the interest of it and the engagement of your learners?
I mean, look, it is difficult because kids nowadays are very much like on their phones, on their tablets, on their PCs all the time. So you have to kind of jump around and do like out of the box things to keep them engaged. And also the maths curriculum is so full. Like we really struggle to get through the work. It really is like a daily struggle. So something that's like quick, that doesn't take up too much time, that really is quite nice for me, that has worked well, is just, you know, when it's like the Soccer World Cup and we're doing like data handling, doing things that have to do with soccer, like we're listing like the number of goals scored or something like that. Or instead of like just giving them a list of heights, actually asking the kids, okay, we're listing all of your heights now, we're putting them on the board, we're drawing a graph with those heights, just so that they also kind of feel involved in it, and so that it seems more kind of real world, because maths in general is quite an abstract thing that the kids really struggle to engage with.
And I'm personally, you mentioning data handling, I love data handling. I like the numbers, the lines, get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Got it. So when you advance to high school, there's usually a time where students get to change over when it comes to from pure maths to math literacy. Yeah. And how would you describe the definite difference between the two for some people that might not know?
So maths is a very abstract subject because we do things like trigonometry and, you know, parabolas and hyperbolas. Oh, you're getting flashbacks now.
Trigonometry, no.
So things that really are actually quite difficult for the kids to visualize. They really are quite abstract concepts, where maths lit is a much more practical subject. So I myself have only taught maths lit for 1 year. In my very first year, I taught grade 10 maths lit. But from what I can remember and what colleagues have told me is it's a very practical subject, you know? They do like a lot of finance things, so they'll work with budgets and with VAT and with income taxes, things that really are quite useful
in your everyday life.
Yeah, where in normal maths, I mean, we never even talk about income tax, you know? They'll do things like perimeter, area, which I think can work quite well as well. And you know, if you need to paint the wall, you need to know how much paint you need, that kind of thing. So yeah, maths is more abstract, maths lit is more practical, I would say.
And I think, just on what you say right now, I'm very proud of myself for taking maths literacy, because yes. now I can apply the maths in my everyday
exactly.
life, the percentages of the maths in the money that I need on a daily basis, you know. So early on we mentioned that you are not only an educator, but you are a content creator in terms of education as well. Yeah. So how do you come about with the content that you put out there? And why is it that you choose a certain content when it comes to what you're putting out?
Yeah, so I think it started during COVID, where there was really a need for, you know, like online content, because a lot of kids were just not going to school and they weren't going to school every day. So yeah, I started just kind of playing around, and you know, during lockdown, I think everyone downloaded TikTok and everyone started just like scrolling. So it was the same for me. And then I started seeing people that do actually like explain things on TikTok. And I started thinking, you know, that's such a valuable thing. If you can explain a concept quickly in like 30 seconds and the kid doesn't have to sit in the class for half an hour and, you know, kind of feel a bit bored, because it is like you say, kids kind of switch off as soon as they're in maths.
They want something fast-paced, something they can grasp really quickly.
Yeah, and also something that they can watch over and over again. Whereas when you're in the classroom, you can only explain something so many
and
times.
And I don't think anyone wants to be that student to be like, ma'am, I don't understand, but thank you so much for being here.
I know
time has been cut short, but I know you're still here. She's still in the building. She's going to be hosting an amazing game called Buzz, so you do not want to miss it. But right now, a quick something that we love on EKSE, taking a break, and we'll be back with more after this. Do not go anywhere.